Hey everyone, so in the last video, we saw how we can send automated email by using the SMTP activity of UiPath. Now in this video, we'll see how we can receive mails and at the same time download attachments by using the IMAP protocol, which is nothing but a protocol which is used to receive emails on the receiver side. So let's get into it. We'll start by creating a new process. Let's give it name IMAP example and hit create. So the task which we wish to accomplish in this video is, I have this Excel file and it has some data in it. Now let's say this is a report which I receive every now and then in my email, and this file is attached in that mail with a particular subject. I need to open the mail, download this file and store it in my system and then work on it. So we need to automate this process. Our workflow is ready. Let's open the main workflow. So in the previous video, we had something like SMTP or send SMTP mail. So similarly for receiving mails, we have an IMAP activity. So if you go to your activities panel and search for IMAP, you'll see you have a get IMAP mail message activity. So I'll drag this activity here. Now for getting a better view, if you go to the properties of this activity, you see you have various fields which you can specify. For example, the mail folder field. Now this is the folder from which our messages will be fetched from. It is by default set to inbox, which is fine. We need to specify the port number and the server of IMAP, which we will do later. We also need to specify the email and password of the account from which we are trying to fetch the mails. Now we have certain optional field also, like the delete messages field. If you check this, the message will be deleted upon fetching it. You can specify certain filters on the messages which you are trying to search according to date or the sender or anything else. You can mark the message as read upon fetching it, and you can also sort them by newest or oldest. You also have a field of top. Now this top count, let's say this is specified to 30 by default. So the top 30 messages would be searched in order. So we don't need to do that. We'll give a smaller number, let's say 5. Now for the port number, we'll give the port number of IMAP, which is 993, and I'll be using the Gmail server, so I'll give the IMAP of Gmail, which is imap.gmail.com. Now for email and password, as you saw in the previous SMTP video, I didn't provide email and password explicitly in this field. Instead, I used an get credential activity so that I do not have to populate these fields here. I'll place and get credential activities here. Now it will fetch the asset which is already stored in orchestrator. It has the username and password of the mail which I am trying to access. Now this activity will give the username and password of the email account. So I'll fetch it by storing it in a variable. For password, I'll give password and username as username. Now I'll use these two variables in the IMAP activity. For email, I'll pass the username, and password I'll give in the secure password field. Now this is done. Now let's come to the optional field. Now let's say once our message is read, I want to mark it as read, so I'll tick this field. Now let's assume I receive the mail under the subject of new task every time the mail is sent to me. Now I need to filter all the mails which contains the subject new task, open it and download the attachment for it. So we need to provide some kind of expression in this field. So if you are not sure how to specify the expression, you can always head out to the documentation of UiPath, where you can see detailed analysis of all the activities which are available in UiPath. So if you see get IMAP mail message activity, you can see the properties which we just now saw. You can see here are some filtering examples which we can apply. We can filter mails according to the subject. We can also filter them according to the sender from which they are coming, or specify not from. We can also filter them according to some particular message in the body, some flags, or we can also filter them some particular date and so on. So I need to get a particular subject, so I'll copy this expression and I'll paste it here. Now my mail will be containing the subject of new task, so I'll specify it here. Now this is set. Now this activity will give a list of all the messages which match this expression. So we'll store it in a variable, let's say mail messages. So this is done. This activity is set. Now after we have fetched all the matched mails according to our expression, we need to store the attachment of the mail in our local system. For that, we have a similar activity called as save mail attachments. So if you search for it, you can see you have a save attachment activity. You can drag it just below this. Now in the first field, you need to provide the message from which the attachment is to be saved. So our variable name was mail messages. Now this is a list of all the messages which are matched according to our expression. We need only the first one out of it, so I'll give an index of 0. Now if you look at the properties of this activity, here is a folder path. Now this is the path where the attachment would be saved in a local machine. So if you don't provide any value to it, the file will by default be stored in the project folder. So let's open the project folder. As you can see, here is nothing as of now. We'll check this out later. Now that the attachment is saved in our local machine, we can navigate to that file and open it. Since we know that the file is an Excel file, I can open it in this process itself. So I'll open an open application scope. Now here I need to indicate the type of application which I wish to open. So the application is Excel. So I'll close this. I'll come back and indicate the Excel window. So an Excel application is opened, but we need to open a particular Excel file. For that, if you go to the properties of this activity, we can do that by specifying the arguments field. Here we can provide, we can explicitly provide the path of the file which we are trying to access. So if I open the advanced editor, we know the file will be stored in a project folder. So let's copy this path. But as of now, we don't know the name of file which is going to be stored. But we have the variable which contains that file. So we'll access the name of that file through that variable. The variable was mail messages, and we need to get the first matched email out of that. I'm trying to access the attachments in that message. And out of those attachments, I only want the first one, and I need to get the name of that attachment. So I'll give it by dot name. This is done. Now our process looks complete. So let's navigate to the mail. Now this is the mail from where I will be trying to fetch the matched mail. So let's send a mail to this account. I'll compose a mail from a different mail ID. And the subject, as we saw, we need to specify as new task. Now I'll attach that Excel file. It's here. Click on send. Now let's refresh here to see if we have received the mail. So the mail is here with the subject of new task and that Excel file attached to it. Now let's run a process to check it. So I'll go to debug and run file. Let's see what happens. I'll close this Excel. As you can see, our robot has started. The attachment was downloaded. Now it has been opened in the Excel file. As you can see, this was the file which we sent as an attachment. If you also check the project folder, you can see the file was downloaded in this particular folder. And also if you refresh this mail, you will see the mail was read as we specified in the mark as read field. So this was the IMAP activity. through which you can receive mails, filter them according to your need, and also download attachments. Thank you.